Welcome to the skate park of Tampa, home of the legendary Tampa Am and Tampa Pro contests and the infamous Converse Concrete Jam. And today, it's the site of the long-awaited finals of the Converse Concrete JAMdemic, a digital contest featuring some of the best concrete transition skaters from around the world. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. I'm Paul Zitzer, along with my favorite partner on the mic, founder of Skate Park of Tampa way back in 1993, Mr. Brian Schaefer. Thanks for being here, Brian.
Thank you, Paul Zitzer, and thank you so much for the incredible introduction, as always.
My pleasure.
Thanks for pulling me out of retirement to be here for today.
Mm-hmm.
And then I wanted to thank the entire world for tuning in.
Mm-hmm.
And we want to thank Converse. We want to thank all the participants and everybody for watching in and being a part of At Spot Tampa. So thank you guys very much. On this show ahead, we have $1,000 for the Concrete Best Trick Contest.
And this trophy, somebody's going to be skating out of here with this today.
And then, thanks to Converse as well, $10,000 is going to be up for grabs for the top three guys only.
Mm-hmm.
And this trophy as well. Some first place winner
mm-hmm.
to be determined will walk away with $5,000.
All right, we started with hundreds of skaters from around the world. We told them, post your runs to Instagram, hashtag them. Top 30 skaters made it to the semis. And then the top 12 advanced to the final. You're seeing them on your screen right now. Semifinals was such a gnarly cut, but we have such great judges, a celebrity crew. You're gonna meet them soon. All right, Chris Russell shut it down in the semis in a huge way. He teamed up with Chris Gregson, Follow Film extraordinaire. And look at this run. Russell was just flying. He skated three different bowls and did a million tricks and qualified first place into today's finals. So here's a look at all 12 who made the cut to this round. But two of those skaters you are not going to see today, they are scratches for the finals because they didn't get us their runs on time due to reasons unknown. Pedro Barros, Tate Carew, they are out, scratched. They're going to be replaced by 13th and 14th place from the semifinals. That was Iago Magalhaes from Brazil and Hampus Winberg from Sweden. Congratulations to both of those guys for making it through to the finals. And thank you, because they had 2 days to film their finals run and they came through and put it down. Today is going to be super hard to judge this contest. I'm going to tell you why. 12 skaters in the finals had 1 month to film, so you got to assume everybody's turning in their best stuff. How do you judge it? Thankfully, we have some of the best judges in skateboarding here today. Let's bring them in.
The world's best judges here today. The world's best panel.
Yeah.
Friends of ours, friends of the skate park of Tampa, and known throughout the world. So, three judges. We're going to bring in Tomyoto team manager, Nike's professional talent scouting man himself, the pioneer of X Games Real Street, and a good friend of ours, Mike Sinclair. How you doing, Mike Sinclair?
Doing good. Stoked to be here.
Hey, Mike, what do you think it's going to take to win today? There's 12 skaters. What are you thinking right now?
Well, we saw some great skating in the semifinals. I think dudes are going to step it up. To win, it's going to be a full run. It's going to be crazy stuff that no one else is doing, and I'm excited to see it.
Well, it's you're a professional. That's why we keep having you back, and we're stoked. We know the results are going to turn out right. We're looking forward to seeing every run as well. So now we're going to bring in my favorite from the semifinals, Mr. Creature Fiend himself, the General, Darren Navarrette. How you doing, buddy?
I'm doing good. How's everyone doing?
We're good.
Doing awesome. Let me ask you this, Darren. Did you get any feedback from people who may have seen the show? Because you were on one. We liked it.
No, honestly, I didn't watch it because I was embarrassed to see myself. So, and it's being a judge is difficult because people judge judgments. So it's like, I don't want to be judged for my judgment. So I actually didn't watch it.
Yeah, no, that's okay.
I know for a fact when Lance Mountain says Darren Navarrette killed it, Lance couldn't judge today, he had prior engagements. But when Lance Mountain says Darren was my favorite, everybody, you were their crowd favorite.
Speaking of Lance Mountain, yeah, there you go.
That's an old throwback to Tampa Pro.
I got this trophy once from Tampa Pro, this one was just awarded just for showing up. So that's kind of what we do all the time, is just show up.
That's so sick, man. Yo, Lance, I hope you're tuning in. That's the Vert Homage 20 year that Lance did that year with us. And so the world's best judges here wouldn't be complete without Spot Team Rider. We love his dad. He's making waves throughout the world. And this is Zion Wright. How we doing, Zion?
What's up? How are you guys?
We're good, man. I was just telling a story how I met Zion. He would always just be at the session. He'd be like, hi, and introduce himself. You're a gentleman. You're a G, a force to be reckoned with, and we're stoked to have you on the panel.
Thank you. I'm stoked to be here. Let's get some judging going.
So I think, Zion, you could be in this contest. You could be in the top 12. So what are you thinking, seeing the semifinals coming in here, what do you think it's going to take on the concrete battlefield to win this contest?
It's going to for sure, I feel like, take some creative skating, some different tricks, and just like, yeah, some just going all out big. Yeah, so.
Yeah, it's sick, man. So let's get down to it. Paul, take it out. Take it away.
All right, so with the finals about to begin, we got a curveball because we're doing concrete best trick starting right now. We had people submit tricks on the hashtag concrete best trick for the last month. And we have $1,000 to give away courtesy of Converse. Now what's funny is the selection of tricks that a lot of people went with was so wild and wacky and weird. It's like, I don't know what planet some of these people are skating on, but it was pretty entertaining to say the least. So here's what went down in Concrete Best Trick, Brian. This is just the start. 270 nose pick to Scooter Bash.
Ooh, slow replay. I like it. Well, this is the montage before we get to the top five, right?
Yeah, these are just a few of the submissions. Oh, we got Pedro Quintas. Heel 270 to Sugar Cane. Hampus, alley-oop nose grab, 540. 360 flip tail grab, the Mako Urabi.
The double kick flip. Tony Hawk squat on the back. Oh, that's our boy,
oh, spot
Peter.
Tampa. Yeah. All right, some people are getting super creative, kind of. All right, we got a girl in there doing a Miller flip. Bigger spin disaster, sit on it. Lots of sit on it's here. A champion over the hip, 360 varial. So as you can see, a lot of wacky tricks, really good ones. McTwist
sure
over the hip.
I like it.
People ripping. Just a big air over a volcano.
Man, these guys didn't make the top five. I do see why, but hey, we had to show everybody from around the world. Look at this. He just won his own contest. He's so excited. The world is watching him right now.
Hey, let me point out, Brian, that's the dude that won best trick for the global AMdemic.
I think he's just re-celebrating the global AMdemic win right there.
We're stoked for him, but he didn't make the top five, unfortunately. But he made the top five in our hearts.
That's all right. We love you. And we got $1,000 to give away, but here we go, coming up to the top five.
Fakie 540 tail stall on the side.
Originality, an all-time 10. I'm not judging the whole contest, but that's fifth place.
Fourth place, Ericles Fagundes. We saw him in the semis. Fakie big spin front blunt. That's a pretty heavy move.
That is a heavy move. At the TF, the California skate parks, they're stoked to get the background props.
Yeah, that's you got to work the shoulders for that one. Third place, concrete best trick. 360 flip tail grab, kind of late shove it with the hand.
Wow. I almost have to do that in slow-mo and put on your glasses, Paul.
Lucas Denise. Pretty sick. Second place. Here we go. Jack Winburn.
Muscle T. Front blunt off the top rope.
That's a heavy move. That's a dangerous spot to be in, front blunted up there. If you slip over, Brian, you slip over on that, you are dead.
I agree, Paul. I like the hype, Paul. I like the hype.
First place. Concrete best trick, $1,000 in the bag. You guessed it, Brian. His name is Bradley Pitchler. Fakie big flip, blunt, fakie flip out.
Oh my God, and guess what? We'll watch this in slow-mo and see how he's gonna get to walk away for $1,000. Let's take a look at this trophy right here.
He's sick. Congratulations, Bradley.
Got the trophy, $1,000. Thank you, Converse, and thank you for everybody for tuning in and being a part of Best Trick.
Hey, but Mike, which of these tricks, if you had to pick one that you were going to do, which one do you think you could have possibly made?
Me?
Yeah, you.
I would have tried the front blunt, which I couldn't even do front blunts, and I would have fallen over the back. They would just see me try it and disappear.
Zion, I'm pretty sure you could do all these tricks easy.
Yeah. I wouldn't do those. A lot of those trick selections. I wouldn't venture off to trying those tricks.
No way.
I like that. I like that little bit of secret hate in there, just sliding it in there.
Hey, and just for the record, the reason why Zion is judging this contest is because he says he didn't get the email on the invite. Yeah. Thank you. Thanks for missing the email, Zion, and being here with us today.
Yeah, we sent it, but at least you got the one to judge, so we're stoked you're here.
I told you guys to text him and not email. Text is the way to go. No emails. No one reads emails. Texting.
My bad. I was just having fun, you know, just straight.
All good, Zion. All good.
All right. Hey, before we kick off the finals, guys, thanks again for being here. Good luck today. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be back with more right after this.
Yeah.
Welcome back to the skate park of Tampa. This is the Converse Concrete JAMdemic. I'm Paul Zitzer along with Brian Schaefer.
Yo!
And the finals are about to begin. But first, Brian, let us talk about how the judging is going to work today.
They're going to be looking for difficulty, execution, variety, use of the course, style, and the runtime. We gave them a minute to throw it all together. Some of the guys pull out early, looks like they could kill it, but sometimes the length of the run is such an important factor. So how the scoring works, we have three judges, the world's finest. We give them a scorecard from 0 to 100. We average the remaining three and the highest score wins. Mm-hmm. It's as simple as that.
We don't drop the high and the low?
We don't drop the high and the low.
Let's talk about some stats, Brian. Numbers from the finals. Average age of finalists, 20.5833 repeating years old. That's how old the average skater is.
20 and a half years old.
That's right. Two youngest skaters here in the finals today, Gavin Bottger from California and Hampus Winberg all the way from Sweden. We've got a few 24-year-olds today, four of them. Chris Russell, Elijah Akerley, Jonny Gasparotto, and Steven
Pineiro.
Yeah, those are the oldest dudes in the finals, all ripping. Four countries made it into the finals. We mentioned Sweden, we mentioned Puerto Rico, and that's all that's left is the U.S. and Brazil.
A great turnout, an international concrete jam, and we're stoked to be here.
Indeed. Let's talk stakes, Brian. Who gets what here today?
The stakes is high, Mr. Zitzer. $10,000 is the purse. First place gets $5,000, $3,000 for second, and for third, you walk away with $2,000. Not a bad day's work for a minute run, mm-hmm. I would say.
Brian, let's talk about the finals format. It's so simple. 12 skaters in one heat. Each skater gets one run up to 60 seconds, and the best run wins, period.
That's it.
This is the start order of the 12 skaters you'll be seeing in the finals. Coming in first from Sweden, Hampus Winberg, followed by Iago Magalhaes, Taylor Nye, Elijah Akerley, Riley Kozerski, Steven Pineiro, Augusto Akio, Luigi Cini, Gavin Bottger, Jonny Gasparotto, Tristan Rennie, and Chris Russell. Let's get to it.
All right, let's go.
First skater coming in here in the finals of the concrete, JAMdemic, coming out of Varberg, Sweden. He's 14 years old. It's Hampus Winberg. And take a look at the bottom of your screen there. Run length. He turned in a 40-second run. That could be crucial when the scores come in. And Hampus is in.
Big carve.
Boom! Wow, that was a huge backside air.
Mega air. Double carve, setting up little frontside air.
Big front set air. That was not good.
A little tuck knee, back tail, little pop in. Little man got a big back tail. Setting up again.
He's going fast, too. I like it. Nose grab, 540.
Yep, Zion's got those in his sleep all day long.
True. Kicky Indy, too. Zion's got that. Front blunt for sure. All right, little ollie to fakie. He's kind of losing speed.
That's all right.
That's it. 40 seconds.
That was a quick ender. 40 seconds, I think, will be a deal breaker on seeing where he ends up, you know. But right now, I think the judges have no choice but to put him in first place. So.
Dude, but he killed it. He did a lot. He went high. He
did the front blunt.
He worked the ball. So it's not like he just did 40 seconds and nothing. He was shredding his face off.
You're right.
There you go. Scores are in. 76.33, that's a good average score. But look at the spread right there. 69 for Sinclair, 83 for Navarrette. That's 14 points.
Vertical vampire, you know, maybe there's a little bit of favoritism there for Navs, who knows?
That's okay, let's take it to Navarrette and see what he loved so much about that run. Darren.
Yo, Navs.
You loved it.
Yeah, of course I did. I mean, look at this kid, what he's doing. And I wasn't judging low, I wasn't judging high, because 100 would be high. 60 would be low, so I thought 80 was somewhere in between that. So that's what I'm looking at. Like, now if you get an 88, 89, if you get a 90, then you're up there. So I just figured that was a nice average score for a kid that's big.
We back it. We like what you're saying out here today. But Sinclair, I mean, low.
I say average is 70. So we got a discrepancy on where the average line is.
Oh, fair enough.
I don't think he got what he wanted. I think he turned in what he did the best at, and it wasn't a full run, and it was some good stuff in there, but I gave it a 69, and I think it's just, I think it was kind of average.
No problem. Great input there, and since this is the first run, they're getting on the scale right now. Let's see what Zion has to say. Got some input on this?
Yeah, I got some input. Well, I mean, I like how Mike said the 70 was average, so I gave it like a 77 as far as I like this, everything he was doing going big, but then he did come to like an ending as far as, you know, he like wanted to do more, you know.
Hey, so you know what? We should mention again, though, that Hampus was an alternate. So he only had those 2 days to film, and here was the other alternate. So Iago Magalhaes from Brazil, 23 years old, skating Green Box Skate Park, and again, another 40-second run, but it's because they only had 2 days to film. Let's get him in here. Here we go. He's got some fancy grip
up
tape.
Up on the deck.
It matches the graffiti at the park.
Ooh, I thought he was going to front flip in the deep end.
Yeah, that's flat ground start mandatory. Flat ground, Tampa style, I back that.
It's all right, here he comes. Now he's getting into the contest.
I like that, though.
Using all the terrain, little alley-oop into the quarter pipe. Pool looks epically sick, though.
He's working it. Big frontside tail grab into the deep end. Frontside grind over the hip, keeping it flowing. As you see, he's running out of time here, though. Fakie nose blunt, and he's out, because obviously another bail was in his future. But look at that. Frontside 270 out of the quarter pipe.
You know?
It's not concrete, but we're not going to disqualify.
No, it's okay. Let's pretend it's concrete. It looks gray in the background, but he's using all the terrain, so it's kind of unique. It's a little special. A little 5-0 into the hip. So let's just take a look at the scores.
There we go. 73.67. Once again, a big spread on the scores, but the judges nailed it again. Sinclair with the 65, Zion 73, Navarrette 83. I want to talk to Zion and see, is there anything in that run you couldn't just go do first try?
I mean, dude, it's not. The run's not about me. It's about the kid.
Okay. What did you like about that run, Zion, or not like? How about that?
I mean, I liked how he was going fast and big. He'd flipped his board once, and then he was out of there. So
this is what I saw. I saw he turned in a 40-second run, and he spent 20 seconds of it on the deck before he went into the bowls.
Why I liked it so much is that place looked fun to skate, so that's probably why I judge it so high, because, like, man, I wish I was there skating that. That's kind of where I want to be.
Next skater in. 17 years old from Costa Mesa, California, turning in a 57-second run. Let's bring him straight in. Taylor Nye, here we go.
Rolling him front side. Starting it out the big 5-0, right into the 540.
Everybody's got the nose grab five. I know Zion's got that trick too.
I know.
Back tail around the corner, I like that. Anything around a corner gets props for me. And any kickflip stale.
A little stale.
Have I told you, Brian, my arms are too short to grab stale?
T-Rex arms? I know that, Paul. I can tell your style.
Sean Penn. Little tuck knee invert.
Playing the hand.
That's cool.
Little slide around the corner.
It's tweaked indie to fakie. He's doing a lot of tricks. He's packing it in, hitting all parts of the ball. That counts.
It almost looks like he's losing speed. Maybe he needs some new bearings. You know, he's almost to the lip, and it looks like he's getting pulled back.
He's doing a lot, though.
He is, man. Long run here. Time for another trick.
Back D revert, and he's out. I mean, hey, 57 seconds.
Longest run so far.
He did a lot of tricks. Here's a look. Nose grab.
The 540.
What else? Here we go.
Kickflip sailfish.
How do you grab that?
I don't know. I've never done it.
And the backside air over the hip. See what the judges think. There it is. 76.67. So that's good enough for first place for Taylor, but just barely. Zion coming through with a strong 82. Zion, what did you like the most about that run?
I skate, right? So I could tell, like, you doing a lot of tricks, like, dude, you get tired, you get winded. So he seemed like he was gassed up doing a lot of tricks. So I don't know.
I back that score 100% because if you think about it, if you're doing a kickflip stale in the middle of a run, I mean, that's a super tech trick. You bail that 2, 3, 4 times and pretty soon you're Zorch. You're like, I can't do this run anymore. I got to come back tomorrow.
I agree. So do the judges.
Coming out of Lewiston, Maine, known as Stoned Spork, skating the Flower Shop DIY, so a different park than he skated last time, turning in 47 seconds of mayhem, Elijah Akerley. Look at that park. This is sick. All right.
Oh, I love the different terrain. Look at the graffiti. Tight. Everything's tight in here.
That place looks tiny. Those are the hard spots to hit. Look at that.
Mixing it up, though.
I like the filming, too.
This reminds me of that spot we found in Australia in that warehouse all graffitied up.
Exactly. You're right. He's milking it for everything it's got.
Nollie to tail off the wall.
Sure. It looks really insanely hard to skate. Lip slide in that deep end. How steep is that place? It's ridiculous.
I need to get there. We need to get there. Look at that DIY. It is super sick. That's going to wind it down.
So no kickflip indies, no McTwists, but we do have the nose grab 540 rock and roll. And wall jam nollie out to tail. Front feeble in that real steep corner. I mean, that's hard skating right there, Brian.
It is, and it's different terrain, but, you know, top 12 around the world, this is what the judges are looking for, the terrain, the skaters, and the talent right now. So let's go take a look at the scores.
Scores are in, 74 even for Elijah. That puts him in third place behind Hampus. I'm going to want to talk to Navarrette about that one. I'm curious. I feel like Navs likes the vert dudes who are doing the vert tricks more, but here we see him kind of backing the dude going the weird route, which is
DIY.
Cool.
DIY.
Yeah. Navarrette, let's talk.
It's like you're skating in a bathtub. There's no time to think, no time to react. So then you have to be on your game. And that trick he did, I believe it's called a hippie twist.
Wait, which trick was the hippie twist? The nose grab 360 to rock?
Yeah, if you Google search some old stuff, I mean, in our day, you didn't get to Google search it. You had to
go into the mags.
I like the skating. I think it's impossible.
At the end of that, man, it's with that tight DIY space, you didn't have time to think and set up. That's why there wasn't any giant 540s or anything like that. So I back your score, and I back the terrain, and I back the kids' trick selection.
Next skater in, Brian, one of our personal favorites.
Floridian.
23
years old.
Skates
with Frazier all the time.
Skating the St. Pete skate park on this run, turning in 43 seconds. 23-year-old Riley Kozerski.
Here it goes, the humbler.
That's a high air in that bowl.
It is a high air. Paul, this is your favorite bowl, I've heard.
Wow, there's the McTwist. Mute grab, too, with like 3 feet of vert. This bowl's just really hard to skate because it's so steep. But Riley's got some of the smoothest flow around. He's very casual, yet does super hard tricks like that. Frontside boneless through the corner.
Super sick. Little pogo rock.
A Bennett grind, and then the old Losey thruster no grab.
That's for Navarrette. Whoa. Navarrette loved him. Navarrette's going to give him 100. I heard him talking about that earlier.
And then he's got the barley around the corner. Oh, Phillip 66 late
in
bail.
The humbler.
That's gnarly. That's a gnarly run.
If you skate that bowl, you know how hard it is. So it's really hard to understand how hard it is to get over the lip every time.
That's a beautiful McTwist. But Brian, I would say this. I'd say 9 out of 10 skate spots, you say the same thing about. If anything you've been to, you're like, most of it is hard to skate, right? Very few things. It's like, oh, that place is easy to skate. So it's hard to say. Bailing out on the Phillip 66, though. So that was an interesting run. That could go either way. Great, great, great stuff. Really hard tricks in a hard-to-skate bowl. Scores are in 77.33. Guess what? That is good enough for first place for Kozers. So okay. He's looking at $5,000 for that run if he could stay right there. Navarrette, I heard you were going to pad up for these finals. But what do you think about Riley Kozers? You love him? You don't like him? What?
Well, here's where being a judge is not very right, because I have favoritism. Judgment is favoritism. I like this guy a lot, because what I see in this guy is he's doing his own thing. He's not following any path. He's not doing what we see, what they did. He's doing his own thing. He's not trying to be this guy, or this guy. Maybe he is, maybe he's not, but I see originality. So he's my favorite skater. So I give him first place, even though my judging, I mean, I'm trying to be fair, but I hate judging. He wins.
You are fair, and you aren't judging, but you are. You're killing it. And Lance Mountain, I think, would have the same feelings right now if he was here, because he is different, and he is skateboarding.
Well, you guys nailed it. He's in first place right now, I think, where he belongs. Zion, what did you see that you liked in that run?
The big boneless from corner to corner.
Yep.
That was really sick. And then the barley grind and the Bennett grinds, those were sick.
Did you see the foot plant of the fake like foot plant?
Yeah, that was sick too.
Can you do those?
No, I can. Okay.
We want to see you do this, because I bet you could kickflip into that.
Setting the bar. Just setting the
I'm
bar.
I'm with it. I think Riley's original. I like his trick selection. It's something you don't see every day. He did it with rad style, like a perfect McTwist, and then you don't see the barley and the grind in a bowl or a pool ever. So he kills it.
Hey Darren, have you done a Phillip 66?
I've tried. No, I did a Phillip 16.
On deck from Puerto Rico.
Puerto Rico.
24 years old, skating the CATF skate park in San Diego. Turning in a 46-second run, it's Steven Pinheiro. Hey, so listen to this, though, Brian. Steven's claiming that his camera died at 46 seconds, or that his phone died. So there was more to this run. Let's check it out, see what happens.
Well, it's a good disclaimer, but if the judges can only see 46 seconds.
Oh, that was
that's what he's being judged
beautiful
on.
Front nose blunt.
That was nice.
Working it.
I am a big fan, man. I saw the Puerto Rico skate park that he skated in to get to this through the semis to get to here. Now he's on the other coast of the world.
Kickflip frontside air with the tuck knee. We'll have to ask Mike if he likes that better than a kickflip indie. So he's hitting all parts of the bowl.
And transfer over the spine.
So Brian, in a text, he told me that he did a 540 after that nose blunt at some point. So that got cut off. Imagine that. I mean,
maybe we shouldn't talk about it. It might give the judges.
It. As far as we're concerned, he bailed. He bailed right after that nose blunt. So let's take another look at some of what he did. That front nose blunt coming in was beautiful.
That beautiful brand placement for the California training facility back there.
That was a good back tail.
Huge. He skated this course right behind us a ton at all the concrete jams. Look at that back nose blunt on the mega extension. Too bad the camera got cut off.
They liked it. 74.33. That is good enough for fourth place, missing the top three. They're all pretty much in agreement. Zion, you skate that California TF some?
Oh, yeah. I've been skating it a bunch lately.
You know what I always wonder is when we see a run like Stevens, is there stuff that we're missing because we don't skate there that you're like, dude, I skate there. That part of the run is so gnarly because, you know what I mean?
I just feel like depending on like who skates it, right? Like if you watch Pedro skate it rather than like you watch Jagger skating, it's like it's a big difference. It's like Pedro's going, like that park is meant, like you can go fast in that park, you know? Or you could go slow, like you could. So I feel like you see someone very explosive going fast skating it, you're like, whoa. And then you see someone doing very technical stuff. It like caters to both of those, you know what I'm saying, type of factors. So
what would Steven needed to have done to bump into the top three in your opinion?
Or you said his phone died and he did a 540. So I felt like maybe he got some spin in there or, you know what I'm saying? A few more technical tricks and his score would have been up.
More time, I think, in general. More time would have helped.
Let's take a look at our current standings after six skaters. Riley Kozerski still up on top with a 77.33, followed by Taylor Nye with a 76.67, and Hampus Winberg, 76.33. Those guys are in the money round. We still have six skaters still to go. So stick around. We got Tristan Rennie and Chris Russell coming up when we come back. Welcome back to the skate park of Tampa. Zitzer, Schaefer, and our crack judging squad. Yeah. This is the Converse Concrete JAMdemic Finals. We have six skaters still to go. Riley Kozerski is currently up on top, followed by Taylor Nye and Hampus Winberg, rounding out the top three. Now let's go to skater number seven.
There is $10,000 up for grabs. The top three could hold on, but these six more skaters could change the whole playing field, and we hope so. We hope so.
Coming out of Curitiba, Brazil, skating that low park. We had so many entries from there in the semifinals. 20 years old, Augusto Akio, putting in 59 seconds here. Let's take a look. All right, this dude has one of the more buttery styles in the bowl.
Well, man, he gets to skate with Pedro. And that's that part.
That was sick. Backsmith revert. Half cab blunt. Front side blunt. Wow. kickflip Indy to fakie straight into a switch frontside ollie over the hip and switch frontside 50. That's hard stuff.
Switch everything. Switch lip.
Little fakie ollie.
Getting turned around. Man, it'd be fun to skate there.
Hey, we got Luigi Cini gave us the invite, the attack, so we're going. We're coming down, guys. We'll see you soon. Front feeble. Oh, putting the hand down, trying to stay on. Backside nose grind up the extension.
Super sick, man. He's killing it.
Back three, still going. Fake Yali towards the heels over the hip. Time. Dude, that run was nuts. It went over a minute.
Look at this. Some replays.
Kickflip Indy fakie.
It almost looks like he didn't grab. It's a little dark.
Switch lip
front lips.
Loose.
Proper.
He did everything so good. And really nice choice of tricks.
I really wish I could do the back nose grind like that over the hips.
You know how you got to do it? You got to practice it.
I agree.
Scores are in. 84 even for Augusto. Sinclair with the 85. Zion, 80. Navra, 87. New leader bumping Riley into second. Taylor into third. And Hampus out of the top three in the money round. Let's go to the judges. Guys, what's not to love about that run?
That run was incredible. He did everything. He did the backsmith revert, which is you don't see often. He did this switch lip slide around the corner with his feet coming off. He did so much stuff. The kickflip into the fakie on the bank and kept going. Just kind of, he didn't spend a lot of time pumping. He spent a lot of time doing tricks. And I thought and they were hard tricks. They weren't just basic. So front feeble, touching his hand on the wall. Everything was just kind of like he was going for it. And it was amazing to see. I thought that run blew the other runs out of the water.
Well, I mean, the dude just threw it down. I mean, trick after trick after trick. I almost couldn't even pay attention anymore. Like, what are you watching? Bop, 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 bop. So it just scrambled my mind. So he's in first because I can't even pay attention anymore.
Yeah, Nabs.
Yep, and he inspired Schaefer to want to learn back nose grinds.
Yes, he did.
Coming in also from the same bowl in the same city of Brazil, 18 years old, Luigi Cini. Look, 59 seconds from him too. Brian, he posted a run on Instagram said, I was stoked to get this run. I was gonna use it for the JAMdemic,
yep.
But then I got a better run and we're about to see his better
awesome.
Run right here.
This kid shreds it.
So he's the one, he invited us down. He said, come skate our bowl. I said, we'll be there. All right, roll on frontside grind just to start. Soggy front tail on a couch. Kickflip over the peninsula.
Every park, every backyard has the old crusty couch.
Don't sleep.
5-0.
You don't know what you're going to wake up with. Whoa, 360 flip. I think that was, what, stale, tail grab? I couldn't tell. That was a proper front feeble. Kickflip, hard flip, body barrel,
call it
whatever you want. We'll talk to Nabs. Burial flip Indy or big flip Indy, depends what area you're from. Kickflip, lip over the hip.
He's got this super dialed. I'm just like mesmerized, speechless, tons of tricks. I'm curious on where this one's going to end up. He's going the limit, over a minute.
Nose slide fakie ender. I like
He's
a nose
stoked.
Slide fakie on transition.
He's stoked.
Salute.
Bro hugs on the deck.
Yeah. That was a great run, Luigi.
Salute.
He gave us what
Cheers.
We came for. Here we go. Look, take another look. 360 flip.
Stay down.
Kick flip, body varial, or hard flip Indy, whatever. And the varial flip Indy, or the big flip Indy, depending on your generation. There, he packed in the tricks.
Man, it is the skating sure is kind of stepping up here.
Yeah, so the score to beat right now is an 84 even from Augusto. Is that run gonna outdo an 84.
Man, Augusta's round was sick. The judges are there. I'm not a judge. I'm going to say it's going to be closer somewhere. It might be a cut maker or breaker up there in the top three. We'll see.
81.67. It's not going to put him in first. It's good enough for second place for Luigi Cini. That bumps Riley Kozers into third, and Taylor Nye is out of the top three.
Ouch.
Or as they would say in sports, off the podium.
Off the podium. Only top three taking the money. 5,000, 3,000, and 2,000.
Let's talk to the judges. Judges, so that run was good enough for second. What would have put it in first?
I just think it's hard to skate the same bowl as the guy that just killed it in front of you. So he did good. I just think that Augusto just murdered it, and Augusto's in first. This kid's in second.
Fair enough.
And good job. Good job, Luigi. You killed it.
I mean, yeah, it's just like, yeah, you look at skating and you see what the difference, and you're like, yeah, Augusto for sure.
So the thing is with this kid, he's so good. He's just sleepwalking through it, man. It's like, you know, he's there, but he's not there. Like, I don't know how old he is. He's young, but there comes a time where skateboarding, it comes out of you so much. It's like Jimi Hendrix. It has to just, So right now the kid is just going through the motions, but the thing is, he's so good going through the motions, he's sleepwalking, that it's his time's coming and we're gonna see something that we've never seen before. But in the meantime, let's just let him sleepwalk through this shit. Like, did you see him? No. Did he see himself? Nah. He's coming through, and then we'll pay attention. That kid is good.
So someday we're gonna wake him up, and then we're all in trouble.
He's gonna wake himself up. No one's gonna wake him up. He's gonna wake us up.
He's in second place right now, so he can only get better.
We have four skaters still to go here in the Converse Concrete JAMdemic Finals. Top 12 concrete transition skaters in the world here today. Coming out of Oceanside, California, skating the Vista Skate Park. He's only 14 years old. His name is Gavin Bottger. Let's bring him in.
Judges, here we go.
Skating the same park that he skated in the semifinals. Coming out, kickflip, frontside air, onto the bank, body varial 540, bro. Varial flip Indy onto the bank. He's doing all the tricks. Hitting every part of the bowl. Back nose blunt. Whoa, that was weird.
It looks so fun to skate that thing. Back Smith on the little small guy. Coming into the deep end, carving for speed. Setting up for something big. What is it gonna be?
Frontside three fly out. Oh, going into another bowl. I like that. All right, front Smith. He's ripping.
Stop playing. Good nabs.
Faking in to what? Cab heel.
Phil Schau. Oops.
Whoa.
Phil Hadjell.
Dude, right. Body varial. No, sorry. Late shove it back D. Towards the end of the run, and then he finished with a backside 360. He did a million tricks. Flip front side air onto the bank. Front three.
I thought he was going to go into the deep end, not to the deck check, but hey, lots of tricks are going down. Instant lip slide into the rolling.
Cab heel. Signature vert skating trick. Hard one to do. And then he did the
lots of tricks in there, man. Lots of tricks, different terrain.
Score to beat right now is an 84 even from Augusto Akio. Ooh. Gavin Bottger taking the lead here in the JAMdemic Finals with an 84.67. Sinclair loving it with an 86. Zion and Navarrette agreeing. 84. Strong scores.
All right. Judges are all in sync, and he only got up there by, like, you know, 0.67.
Mm-hmm.
So it wasn't a jumper in there. It was just barely over Augusto. So let's talk to the judges.
Mike, you love that run the most. Any question between Augusto and Gavin in terms of who should be in first?
I actually liked Augusto's run better, but this one scores higher.
Well, then how does that happen?
I'm not judging on what I personally like. I like them all, but I'm judging on what I think is the right one.
Like, that's how I looked at the whole situation too. It was just like, Gavel did, yeah, tricks like that got scored higher, but Augusto had just like it was just, you know.
Okay, so we have a problem here. We're judging by tricks, what's more harder, but we're not judging about what comes, the inspiration of it. Like, if we were judging Peter Hewitt versus, and Peter Hewitt just did frontside grinds, but you see that explosiveness of Peter Hewitt, we can't give him first place because it's just a frontside grind? That's a shame.
Well, here's the other thing. If we were judging the most stylish person versus the most technical person, we might like the most stylish person, but we're judging tricks. So it's a contest. And how many points can you give style? It's undetermined. It's tough.
I agree. So it's like this. When you judge skateboarding, there's an element of objectivity and there's an element of subjectivity. The objectivity is like, yeah, the tricks are hard. The tricks were high. The grinds were far. The slides were long. And then there's just the feeling and the vibe, and that's where the subjectivity comes in, and it's a balance. And you know, you got to weigh on one side or the other. It's not perfect. What's up, Navarrette?
Then I have to say this, because if you went to a parking lot and saw these guys skating, and you saw Anonis Kappas, you saw these guys, what was your favorite? The one that did all the tricks, or the one that it just, so judging is a very difficult thing, because it was the one that was, man, it just, tricks, fine. But when it just came, play one string, play nine strings, who's a better musician? The one that's technical, or the one can play one string and fucking it makes a noise? So I guess that's what we look at, but it's all a variation of what you see, what you don't see, what you feel, what you don't feel. I hate judging.
Skating the Gumballs Bowl for 44 seconds, 24-year-old Jonny Gasparotto. Here we go. Oh, he skated this bowl in the semis, too.
I like this bowl.
He does, too, obviously. That was a long frontside grind. Huge frontside.
Yeah.
Layback air creatures.
Fiends.
Yeah, I feel like this dude definitely gets extra credit from Navarrette because of the creature connection, but he deserves it because he shreds.
Didn't he have a giant mustache and long hair in the semis and might have tuned it up? I can't remember. Oh, wow. That steep ass hip.
And then into a switch carve. Anybody can switch carve gets props, because that's not a trick, but it's super hard.
Dude,
it's a trick.
Look at that, dude.
Look at him, he's
almost putting in a whole minute there. It's worth it. He killed it.
He did. He super killed it.
I'm proud of the creature, dude. Stale fish. Almost like a backyard pool.
Body jar. And invert over the hip.
Look at that.
Here we go.
Rocking the Converse sticker on the front of the nose. Good placement. Switch carve.
Scores are in. 77.67. That is only good enough for fourth place for Jonny. Just missing the top three and the money round. But well-deserved. Great scores. Of course, Navarrette scored him the highest with the creature connection. Is it the creature connection, Navs, or is it just because, like, you like his skating, so there's a connection?
The kid is really good. I want to go skate there with him. He skated the place, the last one, so it's hard to judge. But I understand where he's coming from. It's like, we did this. You did your same run over and over again, and you added one trick. So.
Yeah. Well, he deducted a trick because he fell at the end. Last time he finished it, so.
I still gave him the highest. I gave him the highest one, which I'm showing everybody. I gave everybody the highest scores out of all the judges. Yeah. I'm actually the skater's favorite because I gave him the favorite, the highest out of all the judges. See, what I did to the judges is when they judged him truly, I gave him fair. It's like, hey, kid.
More board sales for you. Everybody's loving Darren Navarrette.
I'll tell you
more
who's going to sell less boards. Sinclair's board sales are going to fall off a cliff after
oh
this.
Oh, my God. Don't buy that board.
You know what's going to be rad? Next time we judge, Sinclair's going to be like, I gave that guy a 99. I gave him a 99. I gave him a 99. I gave him a 99.
I like it. I like the technique. Who's coming in next? What do we got?
Coming out of the Badlands, California, skating the Desert Skate Ranch skate park this time. This is a disclaimer. Skating a real pool with a skate park built around it. Putting in 59 seconds of work. 22-year-old Tristan Rennie. Here we go. Chris Gregson filmed this run, by the way, so you know it's going to be good. Kickflip Indy, Mike Sinclair's favorite trick to start off.
Look at this little happy land. The colors. Filmer even makes the skating look better.
Back three.
Where is this spot?
It's on the moon right here. shooting the tunnel, over the capsule, front blot on a steep quarter pipe.
I gotta get here. Navarrette, we gotta skate there.
That place looks fun. I'm sure it's not as easy to skate as he's making it look, though. I promise you that.
Look at this little...
He's like taking us on a tour. There's the real pool we've been talking about.
Is that where he skated when the dog was running around? That little guy?
No.
That was a different one, but I understand. Yeah. This is the OG pool, skate park built around it. Somebody's lucky.
Bad blunt. So a minute of hitting every single thing in his path. That was kind of a weird run, though. Different, like mixing
kind of
it
soft
up.
Terrain, a lot of rollers. You know, I loved his other run in the semis, but I'm not judging this. This is where he started it out.
Kicky Indy, tuck knee, 360 out.
Real pool, though. Back blunt, proper. No barking dog like the last video.
So obviously a great run because the dude rules. Different.
Yes, he does. Yes, he does.
I'm not even going to talk about it. I'm leaving it up to the judges. Let's see what they think. The score to beat right now is an 84.67 for first. Only good enough for a 78.33 for Tristan. That puts him in fourth place, just outside the top three. Darren, have you been to that spot? What did we see that you liked or didn't like? Or what do you guys say about Tristan?
I like it a lot, man. Is this a cool shot? It's a good shot. It's filmed good. It's
definitely
really cool.
Definitely a cool shot.
What tricks do you see in here? Do you see good tricks?
Is that Tristan's run?
No, that's not Tristan's run. I'm just talking because look at these knee pads. Those knee pads are really cool. I mean, I'm going to order these tomorrow. Anyways, Tristan rips. He's one of the best skateboards in the world. He won combi contest once. I can't judge these kids. They're better than me.
What I saw was a tour rather than a contest run. He took us a tour around the place. It looked awesome. We all want to go skate it, but it's like we're looking for something more. And it looked awesome, but I gave it the lowest score. So that's why my score was low.
Zion, anything?
Yeah, him doing a lot of tricks. Like, yeah, he was just cruising, I feel like, just kind of, you know. Yeah, like just showing the path. But it was sick skating, obviously. He rips. He's super gnarly. So, yeah.
Listen up, guys. There's one skater left here in the finals of the Converse Concrete JAMdemic. He was the number one qualifier, Nav's favorite. His name is Chris the Muscle Russell. I think the muscle is informal. This time he's taking it out east, FDR Skate Park, turning in 59 seconds of mayhem. He's 24 years old. Let's get him in here. Can he take it?
Here he goes. Last run of the JAMdemic.
Look at him. He's skating like he wants to kill someone. And his shirt has already maybe done that. Front feeble on the big wall.
God, man. Lots of cement to cruise through.
I like this
hard
filming.
Park to skate, man.
Is he taking us on another tour? Oh, yeah. Mini loop.
That mini loop carb.
Look at that shirt. Dude.
Frontside rollout.
When FDR attacks.
Back tail around the corner. Oh, so sick.
Hey, that place is not easy to skate.
Front
okay?
board slides.
He's shredding.
It's not over.
Oh, he's taking it into the vert ramp. Acid drop, back D.
I wonder if that still has a Sean Miller plaque on that vert ramp over there in dedication to him. But here we go. Here goes the replays. Front feeble.
That was a heavy move. This is a mini heavy.
Mini loop.
Sidewinder. Extra credit for the shirt, for sure. All right. The score to beat is an 84.67 from Gavin Bottger, who is
Can
up on
he
top.
Do it?
Score is in 79.33. He does not do it, Brian. That means Gavin Bottger is the official winner of the Converse Concrete JAMdemic. Wow, congratulations, Gavin. But let's talk to our judges real quick about this Chris Russell run, which is good enough for fourth place. Navarrette, you had him, what? You wanted him to get the win?
Yes, I wanted him to win. Of course I wanted him to win. I always want Chris Russell to win, but I also want all my friends to win. So no matter what happens, you guys are my friends. So whoever won, I am friends with you. Who cares?
Even, hey, but in all seriousness, Darren, I know FDR is crazy hard to skate, but did Chris Russell do enough there to legitimately win?
That place is hard as shit to skate. I've skated it. It's fucking almost diarrhea. It's fucking hell. It's fucking hell. I can isolate there and skate this little piece of it, but I can't put it all together. No way.
I like how he skated the whole place, and I hear what Darren is saying, and I agree. I think Chris Russell's semifinal run was better. And then this one, I don't think it delivered what he could do. I've seen Chris Russell skate many times, and this was awesome, but I don't think it was enough for the win.
Fair enough, and I agree with you, Mike.
Zion, what'd you think?
The muscle, man. The muscle, Russell, fucking powerhouse. He's fucking insane. He's gnarly. And yeah, I feel like, as far as like delivering that muscle, like to us, like he could have done some sicker shit. But that place is insane to skate. Like Muscle, he's just fucking gnarly. So I love you, Muscle. You're fucking gnarly.
It's been a really, really great contest. The first ever Commerce Concrete JAMdemic. First place, $5,000 goes to Gavin Bottger, officially the winner. And I would say that he officially had some of the hardest tricks in that room, wouldn't you say?
No question. Congratulations, Gavin. He did the hardest tricks and the most tricks. Let's take another look at how he did it. Look, there's a few things to note. He used the entire ball, and he did so many tricks, like the body varial five, the varial flip. He did lip tricks. He hit the corners and the hips.
He did transfer.
Yeah. And then the other thing is, he didn't even just stay in that ball. He used the other one, kept it going. He had lip tricks, cover and drain.
I agree.
Old school, new school, 180s, taking it to fakie. Cab heel. I mean, that trick is so hard.
The body varial disaster.
See, he packed it in, killed it.
I agree.
Once
There's
again.
No argument with me, but it's a tough contest.
No question, yeah. And you know, you could debate all day long for the rest of our lives. That's what we love to do anyway in skateboarding. We'll keep it going.
And he's got $5,000.
Let's take a look at the final standings. With Gavin Bottger up on top, final score of an 84.67, followed by Augusto Akio in second. He's gonna be taking home $3,000. And Luigi Cini in third place, $2,000 for him. Chris Russell just missing that top three in fourth. And then Tristan Rennie, Jonny Gasparotto, Riley Kozerski, Taylor Nye, Hampus Winberg, Stephen Pineiro, Elijah Akerley, and Iago Magalhaes. Congratulations to Bread Blondes taking home $1,000 for best trick. And of course, Gavin Bottger putting it down $5,000, winning the first ever Converse.
They killed it.
JAMdemic.
And Converse, thank you very much for the money. Thank you for tuning in, everybody from around the world. Thank you for following us at Spot Tampa. And see you at Tampa Pro in October. We're out. Thank you. Thank you, Paul. You killed it.
Thank you.